Hello everyone, my name is Marie Berger, I'm a pharmacist and I work at Myriad as an application engineer. I'm here to present you the VideoDrop, a new tool designed for biologists. As you all know, gene and cell therapy are booming and the need for cost control and reliability of bioproducts calls for new technological responses. In the context of CAR T-cell development, and the increased use of extracellular vesicles as a vehicle, VideoDrop can be integrated in a bioproduction process. During a collaboration with a biotech developing an in vivo CAR T-cell therapy, we identified the production of viral vector as complex, expensive, and time-consuming. Scientists are almost blind during the whole process. We figure out that the VideoDrop could be placed at set different points of the production. This clearly validated there was a need for fast in-process control at line. They need a tool for in-process control at line in real time, allowing to measure the concentration and size of viral vector as lentiviruses, adenoviruses or retroviruses, and to see and detect bigger particles and aggregates. I will present you a demonstration of a measurement. This will be very fast. It will take less than a minute. On the right, you can see the device. For the measure, nothing is simpler. You just have to pipette 5 to 10 microliters of your sample and put it on the sample slide directly on the device. Then you close the system to bring the sample to the lens. On the software, you just have to click on play. The processing will last 6 seconds and you will see in real time your sample and the detection of nanoparticles inside. The software will give you the concentration and the size. The rapidity of the measurements allows you to measure large series of samples in a short period of time. After watching the demo, let me give you some more details. VideoDrop can measure the size from 40 nanometers to 500 nanometers and see big objects above 500 nanometers without affecting the measure. Scientists work on expensive samples. VideoDrop requires only 5 microliters. They need to save time. VideoDrop works in real time and is easy to use. They also want to know what they clearly have in their sample. VideoDrop works on raw and non-modified samples without labeling. The method is non-denaturant. We can also work with non-purified sample and viscous sample. VideoDrop is an ideal tool for quick characterization of nanoparticle solution. The innovative idea of the scientific team is to have transformed a standard microscope into an interferometer. The nanoparticle solution is illuminated by a simple LED. A suitable camera and signal processing will make it possible to detect the interferences between the light diffused by the nanoparticle and the incident light signal. The technology is based on three mainstays. First is the visualization. On the same image, VideoDrop allows to switch between a nanoscale detection mode and a microscopy image for a better qualitative analysis of the sample. You can see here, on the image, the presence of macro objects, squared in red, and nanoparticles, which are EVs, circled in orange. The second mainstay is the concentration. VideoDrop measures the concentration of nanoparticles between 1/10 to the power 8 to 1/10 to the power 10 particles per milliliter. You can see here the different images corresponding to different concentrations. On the left, 1E9 particles per milliliter. On the right, 2E10 particles per milliliter. The third mainstay is the size. VideoDrop measures the size of nanoparticles based on the Brownian motion equation. Nanoparticles are tracked to estimate the coefficient of diffusion, which will lead to the hydrodynamic radius. In order to evaluate VideoDrop performances to help the customer being ICHQ2 compliant for validation of analytical procedure, we perform the validation study. This study allows to determine the different parameters made mandatory by ICHQ2 like linearity, accuracy, and fidelity. This study was performed with polystyrene size standard beads supplied by Thermo Fisher. Seven sizes from 80 nanometer to 400 nanometer were analyzed at seven different concentrations within the range of 1.5 10 to the power 8 to 1 10 to the power 10 particles per milliliter. Within this range, we identified the linear range and analyzed data to determine accuracy and fidelity. Every sample was measured in triplicates at three different sessions were performed with two operative and two different devices. In total, 441 measures were done. Now let me present you the result of this validation study. On this slide, you can see the result for the concentration. With the standard protocol defined internally, the identified linear range is between 3 10 to the power 8 to 5 10 to the power 9 particles per milliliter. We obtain a great linearity with the R square at 0.94 within a range of 20% error. The accuracy shows good recovery with a mean of 20%. It is needed to be noted that low concentration can be slightly overestimated and higher concentration can be slightly underestimated. The fidelity study shows an average coefficient of variation under 20%. On this slide, you can see the result for the size determination. With the standard protocol defined internally, the identified linear range is between 80 and 400 nanometer. The accuracy shows good recovery with a mean of 10%. It is needed to be noted that small particles can be slightly overestimated. The fidelity study shows an average coefficient of variation under 10%, which is very reproducible. Now that I presented you the good performances of the Videodrop, I can show you the main fields. Videodrop can be used for two main applications: viruses for virology or viral vector as lentiviruses, adenoviruses, and retroviruses for cell and gene therapy. The second field is extracellular vesicles that are used for vectorization, diagnostic, and therapy. Let me present you the study that was done in collaboration with a biotech named Ixaca. We identified the Videodrop as a new tool for bioproduction follow-up. Here is a simplified scheme of a bioproduction of viral vector from the harvest to the purified drug product. Samples at different steps of a bioproduction can be analyzed in real time by the Videodrop. At early stage of development, results can be used for yield calculation, optimization process, and also formulation screening. At a late stage of development, results can be used as a quality control for concentration and identity for in-process control and final product characterization. On this study, we compare the Videodrop to two other analytical methods for physical titer evaluation of lentiviral vector: the P24 ELISA and the NTA nanoparticle tracking analysis from Horiba. The P24 ELISA takes usually several hours to perform. It can generate bottlenecks and slow the throughput. Videodrop, thanks to its speed, can be a tool adapted for in-process control to streamline the bioproduction workflow. The first comparison, P24 ELISA versus Videodrop, was made with 5 fractions of interest and 2 production batches with the similar process. We have demonstrated a good correlation for physical titer analysis. Videodrop can be used as a tool for rapid physical titer determination. The second comparison was made with another method based on nanoparticular Brownian motion analysis, the NTA, with 5 fractions of interest and 3 production batches. The comparison shows good correlation with a R square at 0.92 and shows very similar values. The 15 measures of Videodrop were done in less than 2 hours, including cleaning and disinfection. With NTA, one measure takes usually 20 minutes. According to the customer, the Videodrop is very easy to use. On the other side, the Videodrop is an ideal companion device to the NTA, as it can allow to efficiently predetermine the target range of concentration of the NTA in a case of full sample characterization. As a conclusion and summary, Videodrop is a perfect tool for biologists to visualize, measure the concentration and size of nanoparticle sample. We work in a single drop, in real time, with a really simple protocol, without labeling or purification, and we can work with viscous and complex sample. Videodrop can provide measures from the harvest to the purified lentivector product. A major step of development is in progress. Myriad has the objective to become GMP and 21 CFR Part 11 compliant during the summer 2021. Thank you very much for your attention, and do not hesitate to contact me if you have any questions.